Hello, I like to make today cake the walking dead. And what we need for this recipe, we need bake two cakes, one large round cake and one small round cake. In total, we need three cake mix boxes. Doesn't matter which one you're using butter cake, vanilla cake, chocolate, any. We need three of those to bake a large round cake. We need mix two cake mix boxes and bake in a round baking pan, which is 25 centimeter in diameter. All inches will be in description box. Please do have a look. Also, if you don't want make a cake as large, you can use the smaller baking tin, like about 20 centimeter in diameter. So this is what we need for the big cake: 25 centimeter in diameter baking pan and two cake mix boxes. And for little one, this is 16 centimeter in diameter, and we need only one cake mix box. So once you bake cakes, they completely cool down, and use the serrated knife to level both cakes so they are flat. Next step is we're using two different types of frosting. For the top small cake, we need just a simple vanilla plain frosting. And for the bottom large cake, we need frosting tinted with a small amount of black gel food coloring to create a darker shade of gray. So what we need is, first we take a cake board and place a smaller amount of frosting in the middle to secure cake. And what we do is we place the first cake on the middle. Just make sure it's nice and secure. And what we do is we just apply a little bit of frosting, actually not in the middle, closer to the front border. So take your top cake and just measure up, make sure it sits nicely in the position, something like that. Reason we do here, because we actually want trim it to place lettuce in front. So we just make a little bit, just have a look firstly how it's sit. And then what we do is we just apply the dark gray frosting and we just attach cake right here. And what we do is we take our serrated knife and we just slice this front right from top down to create like a platform to place our lettuce on. Once you slice front, as you can see, that's how it's look like. So we have a platform now in front to place our lettuce. Whatever, how big you want to make your cake or how large your lettuce, just place them on a piece of cardboard and just place them to make sure they fit into the height and the length of the your basically front of cake. If they fit, it means it's good enough. So what we do is next, frost with dark gray frosting the bottom of cake and front, and top and the sides will be white. So we apply just a thin layer of frosting because we actually want seal our crumbs first and place in the refrigerator after. So we just apply a gray frosting on the bottom and white frosting on top. Once we finish apply frosting, as you can see, we apply a plain vanilla frosting on top and the sides of a small cake, and a dark gray frosting for the bottom and front of cake, whereas we can place lettuce to create like a frame sort of in front. So For now, we just have a thin layer of frosting, so we place in the refrigerator or freezer for about 30 minutes to seal crumbs before we actually apply the second layer. Now we can make lettuce, and I'm making roots walking dead. So what we need is, we need to print template from the internet size to fit your cake. I print a template of lettuce, which is 8.5 centimeter tall and 11.5 centimeter width. You can actually print as whatever size of your cake. You might be want even make a single layer of cake as well. So once you print them, cut them out. In the difficult areas like middle here, so use like a small sharp knife or special type of craft equipment, and then use a cardboard. It just makes it easier to basically in these more difficult areas to, and as you can see, it's perfect template. So what we do is next, roll out small piece of a white fondant in a working surface, spray dust it with a powdered icing sugar to prevent sticking. And what we do is we take one of our letters and simply cut it out. And as you can see, we have very good D letter. So what you do is, once you cut out all your letters from a white fondant, place on non-stick baking paper to set and harden. With a little word "the", you can cut out letters as well, or you can just use simply white writing icing or leftover of your white frosting and just pipe it with that, because letters are too small. Now we can prepare our templates to pipe out chocolate. So first template is for top of our cake, which is main figure in Walking Dead. So print it on a size. All sizes I will place in description box. Please do have a look if you wanted exactly same sizes, or you just simply make your own sizes. So once you print from the internet, what you do is place on the, you can use a tray if you like, or you can use a cake board or anything. You can simply attach the template, and we just secure with tape to make sure it does not move and makes easier to work with. So once we're done that, now we can place a piece of non-stick baking paper on top to make sure we're able to see image, and we again secure with tape. So as you can see, we secure our template, and then now we can see perfectly well. So what we do with our second template, we have actually printed hands. I already attached in a couple places, just using small board. And what we do is we just do exactly something. We attach with a tape to make sure it's nice and secure. And what we do with this one, because we make a multiple sort of, we make four or five type of hands. So we actually cut out pieces of non-stick baking paper, which is we will place on top and pipe on it. So what we do is next, our templates are ready to go. For the main template, we use just simply dark chocolate. For the hands, we're using white chocolate melt and just a few of the pink candy melts, because it just makes a little bit more of the pink, make more like a skin color. So let's melt our chocolates and place them into piping bags fitted with a number 3 piping tip. Now make some hands. So our template is ready. and the chocolate tinted with pink candy melt. As you can see, it's like a kind of skin color we got. So we have small type of skirts as well, short ones. And what we do is we take a piece of our prepared non-stick baking paper. You can, if you like, you can pipe one hand, two hands, or three hands all together. It's up to you. You can make them separately if you like it, and join them together as well. It's all up to you. You can make a different design. I just will pipe two of these design hands. Don't make them too thin, because make sure they're able to stand well. Once it's done, what we do is, I have the just tray here, and what we do, we just simply move baking paper on top, place couple small skewers for support, and just pipe a little bit more on top of our skewer to secure it. You can make like this as many hands as you want to place around the cake. Now we can pipe our figure on for top of our cake. You can pipe on top of the cake board, which is where I touched before. But I thought this would be easier if we have it on a tray, because we can place tray in a refrigerator to just speed up a little bit process to make sure our chocolate is set and hardened faster. So you can also attach on a tray to just make it a little bit easier. So once we place it in a bag, what we do is we start piping according to our image. Go around first. Place two small skewers on the bottom of legs for support, and pipe on top chocolate to secure skewers. If you want to adjust image, just use a toothpick to make it image where you want to see. Once we've done that, what we do is we place our prepared hands and the image for our top of cake. If you like to speed up process, you can place in the refrigerator, or otherwise just leave it on a bench to set and harden. One hands are set. What we do is we use today powder coloring. So they come in little tubes like this. They're often used to color chocolates or candy melts, for example. Also, you can use, if you like, luster powder as well. It will do exactly the same job. So today we're using blue, red, and black. Just take a very small amount. We don't need really that much, because once you're using actually this sort of coloring, you need a very small amount of coloring. So we use our hands as a template, place in front, and we just simply have nice small brush where we can start adding and outshadow our image. Once you finish, what you do is take a toothpick and just make like a line in the middle for. And as you can see here, our image of hands. You can add more or less coloring to make it really, really look like in a sort of a movie. And now we can assemble our cake. Now we can assemble cake. So now we can apply second layer, the bottom large cake. You spread dark gray frosting, and on top just a plain vanilla frosting. So we simply start spraying just a little bit more thicker layer. And once we're done that, what we do is we start arranging the our prepared hands. Once finished frosting entire cake with two different frosting, what you do is place straight away your prepared set and harden the lettuce to make sure it's the whole feet from the bottom. So start actually from a D. Place bottom lettuce first, followed by walking, and if you like, as I said before, you can actually cut out from the fondant or simply pipe from a writing icing, fit it with a number 3 or 2 tip. So once our hands is done, as you can see, they're really cool. So they're a little bit too long, of course. So what we do, just simply break it and set aside all this stuff. And so what we do is, and just arrange around our large bottom cake on whatever area left free. So simply take the large skewer, insert it in to just make sure makes easier, and you don't have to worry about breaking actually the your chocolate hands. And you can arrange in the various basically. You can place more on left or right, or make them a little bit more taller or a little bit shorter. Just depend how much you actually cut off of skewer. So now is left only last thing to place our figure right on top. Now we just simply place our prepared chocolate figure in the middle of the top cake. Just simply pierce with a skewer for two legs to insert in, to make sure to easier to insert, otherwise figure could break some little parts because it's not very thick. And but if you make it, it just makes easier for skewers going in. Well, I hope you like this creation of the walking dead cake. I just want to bring up a little bit closer, make sure you're able to have a look on the words and on the hands. You can of course make the more of different variety type of hands and paint it as you like, and here a fig as well. Also, if you like, you can actually place the like a strawberry jam or the one of those ice cream toppings, like a strawberry topping, on top to just a little bit blood to running kind of everywhere, if you like to do so. Well, everything will be in the description box. Thank you very much for your time with me today. I hope you like this creation. Until next time, goodbye. I just like a little bit added. I added a minute ago the strawberry topping and for the blood. And as you can see, it's really look cool. If you like to have this or other variety of this cake, please choose which is you like. Thank you for your time. Bye bye.